child would develop a trust in the parents. Having trust in parents, the biggest benefit is the child would not lie to you for anything. The child would not need to hide and do things, you know, will not need to do things secretively. So you will know about the intentions of the child, and because you now know the knack of communicating, you can very well communicate this, saying that this is not the right way of doing it. So child is going to listen to you, child is going to develop that kind of a trust that whatever my parents are saying is right. But once they understand that my parents are just against it, makes no difference telling them or asking them, they are going to drift away from you. And when they drift away from you, they get closer to the peer group. So which is a very harmful combination. To conclude it all, lastly, all I can say is you need to lead them by letting them. In the sense, you are only leading them. You are making them follow you. But you are, how are you doing that? By letting them do what they want. Means you are giving them freedom in such a manner that that freedom is being looked upon by you. You are watching over that freedom. You are monitoring that freedom. So you don't give them freedom by being and be and just rest in sleep and be careless about it, that it's okay whatever my child does. You give that child the freedom to choose to do whatever they want, but you are well monitoring whether that freedom is being taken in the right spirit or is being misused or what is been happening. So you lead them that way, you make them leaders in that way, but by letting them give, by giving them freedom. You love them by laughing with them. You have to make them feel that you still love them. It doesn't matter if they have grown up, if they are adults, you are still their parent and you still think good about them, and you show them that love by being friends with them. At each age, the parents need to change their roles to be close to the child. You cannot be a parent for your lifelong to make that child feel secured and being loved by you. That love can sometimes cause the child suffocation. That child could get harassed by that love if it's reflected in the form of being overprotectiveness, if it's reflected in the form of being suspicious and asking too many questions all the time. So you need to laugh with them. Jovial attitude would make them feel that you still love them, you're still close to them. Let them learn to live, but leave them to learn. You have to help them. You have to help them to learn how to live life. See, when they do, it's very difficult for parents. With the example I gave on mental and emotional health of children, I said it's so difficult when you first time leave your child alone in the preschool. Similarly, after the child, after 10th standard, when the first time you have to leave your child to go to college alone, there are so many questions around the parents' mind. The parents are so skeptical about so many things, that whether my child would be into right hands, whether my child would get right kind of friends. Now, these are so many things, but we all have to give it up. We all have to let them. The way our parents have let us lose in college for our growing years, so have we to do with our children. So you need to let them live, let them give, you have to give them the opportunity to live their life. But at the same time, you have to even leave them, you have to let them go to learn how to live. Sorry. And to be like a light in their paths to enlighten their lives. That means it should never so happen that even if your child is not following your instructions, your child is not remained as obedient as he or she was when he was a child. That does not mean you stop giving your guidance. That does not mean you withdraw from them and you tell them that you do whatever you wish to. You anyways don't listen to me, so I am not going to interfere in your life. It's not the question of interfering. It's question of guiding in the right manner. So you are somewhere creating that kind of a path wherein your light is only showing them the way, but indirectly. If you directly tell these children you have to follow this path, they are not going to follow. So it's an indirect approach which can help these adolescents lead the right manner. Thank you so much.